Now I'm going to preach on this word from the Lord, the bondage breaker. God is the bondage breaker. And every word divides by three to the glory of the Trinity. Because God is the bondage breaker, well, he wouldn't get to glorify himself as your rescuer if there wasn't this concept of bondage in the first place. Paul and Silas were in bondage. They were in chains in a prison cell singing praises unto God, and sure enough, God shows up as the bondage breaker. Boom. So even in your bondage, you praise God, because now it's an opportunity for God to show up and prove himself the bondage breaker. And that's one thing I want to say over and over and over and over again. And same with all the following words that divide by three. Difficult, trial, suffer, the root of suffering. I've done a bunch of preaching on all these words. Okay? They all exist by God's sovereignty so that he can show himself all-surpassing in his ability to rescue you and make you fall more in love with himself. So, the bondage breaker. Are you in bondage? In any way, shape, or form, call upon God and he will prove himself the bondage breaker. Hallelujah. And you'll experience him all over again. So do the math yourself. Do the math yourself on the bondage breaker. Every word divides by three. The truth is, we were all born into sin by God's ordinance, and so we were all once in bondage, and so we all needed a bondage breaker named Jesus Christ, and so you just have to worship God for the whole picture. Just say, all right, Lord, thank you for delivering me from my bondage. The Bible says, in everything give thanks. And Paul and Silas made that quite clear when they were in bondage in a prison cell. They were praising and thanking God, praising and singing hymns unto God. And God caused an earthquake to happen. And it says not only were their chains loosed, but the bondage of every single person in the prison was loosed. And the Lord has been speaking to me about generosity and monetary generosity. And monetary generosity is a bondage breaker for not only yourself, but for your entire community. When you open your hand and you give money to the poor, God breaks bondage off of a whole bunch of stuff. And a whole bunch of people get released from bondage of greed and stinginess and fear of lack and the whole nine yards. And the bondage breaker, man, financial giving is a great bondage breaker. Just amazing. Jesus preached on this when he said, if you have an evil eye versus a good eye, that is a Jewish idiom. I didn't know what that meant for a while, but it is a Jewish idiom for being generous versus being stingy. He who has a good eye is a generous person, someone who gives money and has an open hand. He who has an evil eye is a stingy person. Read that verse again out of the mouth of Jesus. It's right in the middle. It's the middle layer in a sandwich where before it there's verses talking about money, and after it there's verses talking about money. It's all about generosity. And generosity is a bondage breaker. If you are concerned, if you are struggling with anything, try opening your hand and giving a generous offering anonymously to the poor, and watch God come through with power. So the bondage breaker. But you, isn't that amazing? You had to be in bondage before you got to experience the breaker. Praise the Lord. That's all you're supposed to do. You do the math yourself. What does this whole thing add to? Bondage 18, 33, plus 3, 36, plus 12, bondage adds to 48. I'm just saying, folks, that is a clinically perfect number before God Almighty. Okay? so that God takes glory in breaking bondage. Well, the bondage had to exist in order for God to show off his power and his ability to break it. So stop worrying, okay, when you feel like something bad or wrong has happened, or that there's something impossible that God isn't capable of breaking. It all is ordained, okay? It all is ordained for God to show himself awesome and loving and all superior in whatever single thing happens to you, his child. Never let go of the fact that you are the child of God. And if a child of a father was in need, the father is going to come through with freedom and power to rescue the child. Okay? So, what does breaker add to? 36 plus 6 is 42, plus 18 is 60. That's another kingpin number in the story of God. It equals pray, equals believe, equals holy, equals pure, equals desire, equals word. 60, the great 60 for the number 3, breaker. So we got two kingpins for the number 3, both divided by 12, differing by 12 points together. This is a divine word from the Lord, bondage breaker. Adds perfectly to 108, which equals worship, divided by 3. And then we stick the word thou in front, that puts it even higher. The bondage breaker now adds up to 141, 3 times the 15th prime, which is in turn 3 times the 3rd prime. It's pure threes, it's pure perfection. And then you can count the number of letters, that's your leisure. You know, 7 exists for the deeper glory of 3. The number 3, bondage and breaker, are both 7 letters apiece, just like Jehovah. 7 letters. And we solve Jehovah in stunning detail for the number 3. So there you go. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Wonderful. And giving to the poor is a great bondage breaker. So there you go. A divine word from the Lord. We solve the bondage breaker. Whew, isn't that just a... Say it out of your mouth right now. You'll get goosebumps in the Holy Ghost. The bondage breaker. That's God. Hallelujah. The bondage breaker.